Do you like a tea or a coffee? I'm not getting lunch, I'm just getting a coffee.
Just oh, not just now then.
Eh?
No, not just now then.
I
There we go. I didn't actually do an introduction, did I? So, what we're doing with this boat, the Blue Marlin, is converting it to radio control. It's a Playmobil, and I've made this pod to fit on the standard Playmobil attachment, or whatever you want to call that bit there. Missing quite a few bits from this. We do have that bit, but we're missing that bit, so I've just 3D printed my own little cover. And I've just printed it upstairs and ran downstairs with it while it was still warm and pushed it on there so it's cooled down, because there's a very slight curve to it. I'm pretty pleased with that. It's not absolutely perfect. You can see there's a few little gaps around there, but all I did was I used a piece of paper to mark out the shape, scan that in to my computer. That's a JPEG file, and then used an online converter to convert it to an SVG file, which I could then import into Tinkercad, and then played with it a little bit to get can't get my finger in there now to get the finished result. So what I actually did was I sized it so it's the right size, then I duplicated it and made the copy slightly smaller, so that's the smaller bit, which is all right there and there getting it smaller, but round here it actually made the circle or semicircle smaller, so I had to trim that out and add my own filler there. I noticed we got a couple of screw holes there, so I added those little pegs to go in those screw holes, and then added a couple of little clips there to grip in place. And as you can probably see, that's got a nice curve on it, and that was a matter of getting it down as soon as it had finished, while it was still warm and pliable, getting it down there so it could cool down in the shape I wanted. So I'm pleased with that. Might do, have a go at doing the bit at the back here as some sort of a raised platform. I'll have to have a look at some pictures. I do actually have another boat, just the same, complete. That's in a box up in the loft, and to save me going up in the loft, I'll just look at some pictures. Alright, just get a bit of soldering done. Put the JST leads onto the motor leads. If you're not familiar with soldering wires, this is heat shrink tubing, which we slide over when we've done the soldering to insulate the connector or the termination, or whatever word is the correct word for it. Actually, I might just grab my helping hand, as it's called. Don't often bother to use it, but it's pretty good. Right, it's really not going to make much difference which way I put these connectors on, because I'm bound to get it wrong and probably have to desolder it and resolder it the opposite way. At the moment, I'm just leaving them there to stop them accidentally touching together when we try it out. But later I'll heat them to shrink them down. Now, these are ESCs. I'm not sure if these have come out my little box where I throw all the ones that are faulty. So they may or may not work. I haven't marked them as faulty, so I don't know. Receiver. I think it's bound to this one at the moment, which isn't what I want, but that'll do. 2S LiPo battery. Actually, it's a lithium ion battery to be exact, and it's on 92%, so that'll do for a test. Got a little splitter plug there, so I can plug one battery in and run two ESCs. Okay, so
Yeah, that's one motor. And that's the other motor.
So, at the moment, that one's on the throttle. And this one's on the... But as for whether they're going the right direction, I'm not going to know using that controller. So I'll change the controller, I'll bind it to another controller. So we'll bind the receiver to a different controller. Turning off, that's better. Right. One of these, the on-off switch is not working. Alright, seems to be alright, must have had one way and one the other. So that's off at the moment. So put the bind plug in. This one on with the bike. I can never remember whether it's that first and then this or this and then that. So we'll do it this way. Oh, before we do that, I need to connect the battery on this one because I've got it running the external battery. Yeah, that's okay, that's power. So press the bind button, switch it on, and then switch this one on. Have we bound? Off. Off. Pull that out. And on. Ah, I remember. I get this problem. On that controller we're using channel 1 and channel 2. On this one, one and 3 I think it is. That's on 3. And this one on... Is it one? I can't remember. Two. Two and three. So we can do that. That. That's how I do it, anyway. So which way are they actually turning? Actually backwards to what I want, and that's the right direction. So that one I want to reverse, or just switch that round to reverse on there. So I could just leave them like that, or I could reverse this one. I think I'll reverse this one.
Okay. So now, I'll turn that back the other way. Right, looking good.
Just a very quick test. I reckon this might well take a 3S. I reckon those motors are better than I thought. Not a lot of room in the sink just to do this. Yep, that'll do for now. Thanks for watching. You'll find more information down in the video description. You might like to watch that video up there. And you might like to subscribe over there.